Hey coders, and welcome to the daily program or YouTube series where we solve different problems which are posted on the subreddit Daily Programmer. In this particular video, we're going to talk about a problem called Condensing Sentences, which is number 319 on the subreddit. And first off, before we start talking about the problem, make sure you spend time yourself solving it on paper and implementing it in JavaScript so that you really practice by yourself how to problem solve. Otherwise, let's go ahead and break it down on the whiteboard. All right, so the condensing sentences problem is like so. If you're given a string, for instance, we have a string here that says, no one ever runs so often. What we want to do is condense the words together so that if there's any overlap, so in this case we have O, so the O's overlap, we should combine them together into one word. And then again, if this one will overlap with the next one, we need to combine it with the next word. Where R overlaps here, S overlaps with that, and then often, again, is another overlap. So in this case, we're going to convert this entire sentence into one combined string. Now, another example we can do is live versus, which is going to be condensed into live RSES. So notice that there's two here that overlap. And then we only use that once. So then if we have a string such as hello world, this would have no condensing happening to it because the beginning of the right word does not have anything that matches at the end of the left word. So now that we talked about the problem and how it's actually defined, how would we actually solve this on paper, right? So if we have another word, so let's go and put the string, again, live versus. If we wanted to check if two words, in this case, I'll say this is the left word and this is the right word, if I wanted to check if the left word and the right word should be combined, what I can do is just continuously look through the left word and shorten the word that I'm looking for from the starting point. So for instance, I can say, does live or live exist at the beginning of the right word? If not, check the next one. Does IVE exist at the beginning of the right word? And in this case, it doesn't. So then again, check if VE begins at the ending of the right word, and it does. So in this case, we know we can condense these words together, and we can do so. Continue on to the next words in the string. So there's two main sub-problems that you can solve in order to solve the major problem. This first one is, given two strings, can you condense them together? And if so, how do you condense them together? Right? And we just show that you just continuously create substrings by knocking off the first character to the left and checking if it exists at the start of the right. All right, so for solving the second subproblem, assume we have a longer string. How do we make sure we loop over every word and condense where possible? All right, so one thing you can do is first we can break this apart by spaces, right? And convert it into some type of an array or list. So instead of being an actual string, we can instead just say that we have an internal array with our four words in it. And over here we have the different indexes of that array. So the first step to do is to take the left word, so I'll say left, and I'll say right, and check if they can be condensed. And if they can be condensed, what you want to do is combine them together and overwrite this slot in the array with the condensed word. So remember the array of index 0, we put the condensed word into, and then the index 1 word we can just go ahead and remove because we already combined it with the previous one. And if you remove something from array, remember that the indices get updated. So then we can continue to do the same thing. And since we just found and condensed a word, let's keep this one the same, so left. But now we're just checking a new right word. So can these two be condensed? No, they cannot. So at this point, what we can continuously do is just change the left and the right, or increment our loop, so that now we have this as our left word, and this as our right word. And then again, we cannot combine these or condense these together, so at this point, we've reached the end of the array, so we can go ahead and break out of the loop. So at this point, you should have a good understanding of how to do this on a whiteboard or on paper, so let's try to convert it and implement it in JavaScript. So like we mentioned before, there's two sub-problems you can solve in order to solve the overall top-level problem. So the first subproblem is, how do you condense two words together and find out if they should be condensed at all? So to start off, let's write a function called condense words, and it takes two parameters, a left and a right, which is the left word and the right word, and then that's going to return null if it can't condense the words. Otherwise, it's going to return the two words condensed together. So starting off, remember that algorithm we did where we had to loop through each substring and kind of chunk off the first letter of the left word. So to do that, we can go ahead and loop through the length of the left word. And then we can say left substring is equal to left.substring of that I, which will go ahead and say give us all the characters, and then give us all the characters starting index 1, give us all the characters starting index 2, until we get to the very last character. And once we have the left substring, we can check to say, does the right start with, I think it's actually called starts with, so does right.starts with left substring. And if it does, let's just go ahead and return that condensed word, which is going to be left plus the right, and then replace that left substring with an empty string. And then up here, just get rid of the extra space, and then we can go ahead and try to test this out to make sure it works as expected. So I'll do console.log, and I'll pass it live, and I'll pass it versus. And again, in the example, this should print out one word combined together. So if I were to run this, we see that it does print out the two words combined. So now that we've written our first subproblem to condense two words together, and that we've tested it out to make sure it works, let's also test it out with hello world and verify that it returns null. And it does. So again, this is a good example of how you solve a top-level problem by breaking it into subproblems and testing it as you develop it. So now we know this one's good, so let's work on the other subproblem, which will be condense sentence, which will take a string, and again what we need to do is loop over that string for each word, and like we saw in the example on the whiteboard, we need to split it first, so we can say let words, I shall do const words is equal to string.split, if I could type, and we're going to split it on the empty characters. Alright, so that'll give us all the words split up, and then finally we want to return those same words but joined together. So then the meat and potatoes of this method is we need to loop over every word one by one. So we'll say for let I is equal to 0, I less than words dot length minus 1, and then increment I. And that's because we don't want to actually reach the end of the string and go out of bounds. So we stop I one before the end. And then again, we have the left and the right, so we can say const left is equal to words of I, const right is equal to words of I plus 1. And then we need to call condense words, so we'll say const condense is equal to condense words left and right. If condense is actually defined, therefore we could have condensed the words together, we need to go ahead and overwrite the first word with the condensed word. Go ahead and rename this to condensed. And then we need to remove index plus 1 or I plus 1. So we can say words.splice I plus 1 and then length of 1, which will just remove the next word since we combined it with the previous one. And then finally, we need to continuously check the same word that we've condensed over and over again to see if it can be combined with the one after. So we can say I minus minus to kind of prevent it from doing this increment up here. So at this point, we can kind of go up here. And in fact, let's before we do this, let's make this a little bit easier. So just so we have less variables to mess around with, we can say there, condensed equals condensed words I plus one. So now at this point, we can change from condensed words to condensed sentence, and then we can change this to like one of those long sentences we had before, which I can just copy this in here. No one ever runs so often. If you run this, see that it prints out all the words combined together or condensed together. And I also have a couple of other ones on my clipboard we can kind of try out. So I'll go ahead and paste those in. So we see no one has ever run so often gets combined to one. Yellow low dog gets combined to yellow dog. The black kettle is hot. We combine black and kettle together since those can be condensed. And then of course, hello world does not get condensed at all. Cool, so that pretty much wraps up how you solve this condensed sentences problem number 319 on the Daily Programmer subreddit. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below, or if you have a different implementation, feel free to post your JS bin or whatever link that you want, and maybe we can have a discussion about other ways to solve this. I saw one solution which uses regex to solve this, which is like one line of code, but I feel like as a beginner programmer, you should probably learn how to manually solve things before you just resort to using regex, although regex is pretty elegant. Again, if you like the video, feel free to give us a thumbs up and then also subscribe to the Free Code Camp channel below. All right, thanks for watching.